But God gave the increase. Pause right there. It says God gave the increase. If God don't do it, it can't be done.
Amen.
I don't care what avenue you're trying to go to or go around to get what you need to go get your stuff. If God don't do it, it cannot be done.
Yeah.
It says God give the increase.
Yeah.
Somebody follow along. Increase.
Increase.
How many of us want increase?
Yeah.
In our finances,
yeah.
And increase in peace. Come on, church. In peace, increase in your faith.
Yeah.
I want increase. I want increase. He said, verse 6, I have planted Apollos water, and God gave the increase.
Yeah.
So then, neither is he that what?
Planted anything. He that watered.
But
God that giveth the increase.
But God giveth the increase.
Come on, man, free.
Stop right there. I need increase.
Yeah.
I need increase. I want you to prophesy to yourself. I need increase.
I need increase.
Come on, come on, come on.
Increase.
Say it, say it. What do you need increase in? Just your finances, better health. Come on, come on. Prophesy to yourself. I need increase. Now to understand this, that it's God that give it. One plant, one water, but God give the increase.
Yes,
increase. I'm talking about abundant stuff that you and I should have. Abundant joy, abundant peace, abundant prosperity, the abundant kind of life. I come that you have life and life more abundantly. I want to have the abundant kind of life. Why do I live beneath my privilege? Why do I don't have the things that I should have? What is going on? Because God is not giving the increase. You can go to school, get your degree, and still not be at the job that you desire or you went to school for. Because if he don't blow on it, it ain't gonna happen. If he don't bless it, it won't happen. If he don't say it's done, it cannot happen. So we're talking about increase. How do I get this increase? I'm glad that you asked. And it's through seeking God like never before. I'm at the point now that I'm like the deer that panteth after the water brook. So panteth my soul after thee, O Lord. Because I'm looking to get my stuff. God, I'm seeking you while you may be found. I'm calling upon the name of the Lord while he is near. Because I got some stuff is mine. Heaven is your throne and earth is your footstool. Oh my God. And so God, you saying that I shall have dominion over the fish of the sea, over the fowl of the air, over the earth, and over every creeping thing that creeping upon the earth. It's time for me to go get my stuff. The earth is the Lord and the fullness thereof, the world and what they that dwell therein. For he hath founded upon the seas and established and upon the flood. Who shall ascend to the hill of the Lord? Or who shall stand in his holy place? He that hath clean hands and a pure heart, who hath not lifted up his soul unto vanity, nor his sworn deceitfully. For he shall receive the blessings of the Lord and the righteousness of the God of his salvation. This is the generation of them that seek him, that seek his face. Oh, Jacob.
Stuff
to replenish the earth. And so why do we don't go get our stuff? If you don't see it, you can't enter it. Oh my God, we talked about that. You got to see it for yourself. You stop seeing yourself as a grasshopper and see yourself as a giant in the sky. But not giving your highest feet to walk upon thy own high places. I don't care what the enemy is throwing your way. It's God that gives the increase. God gives the increase so you can go get your stuff. Say, go get it. Say, go get it. Come on, tell somebody you need it right now. Say, I need it right now. Oh, y'all playing around with it, but I need it right now. Let's deal with this for a moment. 1 Kings, let's go to the 18th chapter. Remember that God gives the increase. See, the king heart is in his hand. And he will turn it. Oh, yeah. I'm not qualified, but God will turn it.
Oh, yeah.
They're not going to prove me. God will turn it. The king heart is in his hand, and he will turn it. But you got to go get it so God can turn it. Faith without works is dead. Come on, church. Am I right? But to get some stuff, there got to be some cleansing. I want to deal with cleansing, the abundance of the cleansing. I'm talking about what can wash away my sins. We talk about nothing but the blood of Jesus. What can make me whole again? Nothing but the blood of Jesus. So you can't get no stuff until your heart is right. I want to deal with something tonight. Can I deal with that? Let's go to verse 41. And we were dealing with Elijah. Someone said Elijah. Come on, church, say Elijah. Elijah name is Yahweh. That's what it is. His name is Yahweh. That means I'm going to make a way through you, Elijah. Now, before we go into let me deal. In 1 Kings 17 and 1, just these notes I want to give out there because I didn't do it last week. He said, now Elijah in 17 and 1, the Tishbite, who was the Pharaoh of Gilead, said to Ahab, as the Lord the God of Israel lives before whom I stand, surely there shall be neither dew nor rain these years except by my word. He said, except by my word. If God's word doesn't perform, it cannot perform.
That's right.
Now, when we talk about Elijah, Elijah was a man that prayed. But it was Elijah that wanted to commit suicide. It was Elijah that sat under the tree and said, I wish I died. But it was Elijah that brought the boy back to life. And so you got to understand that you can be oppressed, but still anointed. You can be crazy, but still anointed. Because he wanted to kill himself. And so you saying, God will use me. Yes, he will. And so when there's those who are anointed, those who are appointed, they deal with different types of warfare, different types of oppression that will come against them. So the enemy will try to stop them so they can go get their stuff. And so no matter if I'm oppressed, but I still got the goods. I'm still God's chosen vessel. I'm still God's anointed vessel. So even through your oppression, God say you can go get your stuff. You just got to fight through it. Say fight through it. You got to hand praise. So we see that he performed many miracles. In 1 Kings 17, 22 to 23, you can write this down. The Lord heard the voice of Elijah. He heard the cry of Elijah. I want to talk about for a moment the voice. What voice are you hearing? It says here in 1 Kings 17, 22 through 23, the Lord heard the voice of Elijah, and the life of the child returned to him and revived him. And Elijah took the child and brought him down from the upper room into the house and gave him to his mother. And Elijah said, see, your son is alive. But I want to talk about the voice. It was Abraham that heard the voice of the Lord in Genesis chapter 12 verse 1, where he said, reason why, Benita, we can't go get our stuff because we want to leave our kinfolks. He said, leave your kindred. The voice of the Lord began to speak to Abraham, because I got something to show you, Abraham, that you got some good stuff, but you can't take Pookie and all your siblings and all your friends with because I got some stuff with you. But some of us take some lots with us. And Lot pitches tent to Sodom and Gomorrah. And so you got to be careful on this journey who you taking with you while you in the process of getting your stuff. Abraham in Genesis 12:1, he said, leave your kindred. He was living in a good life, a nice house. His father was rich. But he said, I need you to leave, Abraham, because requires a sacrifice. Now, he told him, Brother Leroy, to leave your kindred, but now I need you to offer up your son Isaac as a sacrifice. So to get your stuff, you got to sacrifice some things. In Genesis 22, verse 8 through 13, he said, take your son Isaac and offer him up as a sacrifice. And as Abraham took up his son Isaac, about to offer him up, about to kill his son, there was a voice that said, Abraham, Abraham, there's a ram caught in the thicket of the bush. He said, there should be the sacrifice. And so God wants to see how far would you go with him. How far would you show your love towards God? Anybody can love God when everything is fine, but can you love God when things are going crazy in your life? And you say, go get my stuff. How can I go get my stuff when I feel like I'm not even worthy of the stuff? Gideon dealt with insecurity a lot. He said, I'm the least in my father's house. In Judges chapter 6, he said, but there was an angel that had to tell Gideon, say, Gideon, there's some stuff for you. You're a mighty man of valor. Now go get your stuff. We deal with insecurity. We deal with doubt. We deal with wavering. God said, you got to sacrifice to get some stuff. Now, it was Paul, I'm dealing with a voice for a moment. It was Paul that heard the voice of God on his way to Damascus. He said, why kick against the prick, Paul? It's me that thou persecutest. And so, you can hear the voice of God when you're about to do wrong. But still, he got some stuff laid up for you. And so, he had to redirect Saul at that time, his life, so he can go get the stuff and write 13 epistles. And so you be careful. The voice will come when you are doing something stupid, when you are doing something crazy, and God begins to knock at your door and say, no, 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 don't do it. God, you still talking to me while I'm in a nightclub? God, you still talking to me while I'm still gossiping? God, you still talking to me while I'm fornicating? God, you still talking to me while I'm drinking? He still talks to you because there's some stuff for you. And so you can hear God's voice in strange places. It was Moses that heard the voice of God in the burning bush. God began to speak to Moses through a burning bush. He began to speak to Moses, fire by night. Oh my God. He began to speak to Moses. And he began to show himself in the daytime. He came in a cloud. So God would begin to speak to you day and night. But are you listening to the voice of God? In John 10 and 5, write this scripture down. He said, my sheep know my voice, and a stranger they will not follow. To go get the stuff, you got to hear the voice. You got to hear God's voice. Now let me bring some clarity to my deep Christian folks. I heard the voice, and Pastor God told me, Prophetess Tanya, to do this, X, Y, and Z. But it's not lined up with your shepherd's vision. So you're hearing wrong things. The voice got to be checked from your local pastor. Amen. Am I right, church? And so you can hear a lot of things, but don't mean it's the right thing. And so your pastor, your leaders, your elders, your minister got to check that thing to see that thing is right. That's why they say if you have a prophecy, take it to an elder. And then an elder would see if that prophecy is edifying to that church. Because I don't know what voice you hear. The elders got to check it out. Am I right, church? Give God a hand, praise. Stop listening to your emotions and listen to the voice of God. Your emotions is talking more than God is talking. You listen, you govern by your emotions, and you're not led by the Spirit of God. And so your emotions, you cannot go get your stuff, so you can't go get it. Amen. Because what happened is you get on an emotional roller coaster. And then you think that's right and it's not right. And so he said, I got to be led by the Spirit of God. God will lead you and guide you into all truth so you can go get your start.